And our hearts go out to the families.
For the first time, federal, state, and local law enforcement officials are saying Bill and Lorraine Currier of Essex, Vermont, were forcibly abducted from their home in June of 2011 and murdered shortly thereafter. The quiet couple's disappearance had baffled detectives for 13 months, but they say new information has them convinced the killings were completely random.
There is nothing the Curriers did in their personal lives that contributed to their deaths.
Furthermore, prosecutors say they have a suspect in the case, already locked up in an out-of-state jail on unrelated charges, but they would not identify the alleged killer or answer seemingly any questions about the case.
No comment. I'm not going to comment. I can't talk about that. I can't comment on that. I'm not going to comment. I can't say that either. I know you'll hate this answer, but I can't tell you that.
A prime reason for the stingy release of information may be that the suspect has not yet been charged in the Currier's deaths. And the most critical pieces of potential evidence, their bodies, have never been found, despite what investigators now call the largest search in Vermont's history, 11 weeks in a sprawling Coventry landfill, probing 10,000 tons of trash.
The success of these searches is very limited, approximately 10%.
As they have before, police and prosecutors again Friday suggested their case could be put at risk of falling apart if they said too much publicly, including releasing info on the suspect.
I ask that please be patient with what we're trying to do. We are doing the right thing. We're striving for justice in its entirety.
No word on a possible arraignment for the suspect. Meanwhile, the Courier's relatives released a written statement saying, in part, "We ask that all of you respond to this random act of violence with daily random acts of kindness." In Colchester, Jack Thurston, News Channel 5.